Over 2,000 years ago, ancient Chinese scholars observed the changing patterns in our natural world, the climate, the turning of the seasons, and astronomy. The scholars measured and divided the sun's annual movements into 24 equal parts, creating the 24 solar terms, which were used to govern agriculture in ancient China. Even to this day, this invention still guides the lives and traditions of hundreds of millions of Chinese people. On or around December 22nd of each year, Chinese people get ready for the winter solstice solar term. This is a festival to mark the shortest day of the year. It has always been a significant date in the Chinese calendar. Emperors would have held a ceremony. Students might have huddled together, worshipping Confucius, feasting on dumplings for the master. Winter solstice is the 22nd of the ancient 24 solar terms, but it was the very first to be created. Documents show that at least 2,500 years ago, the ancient Chinese concluded that in the northern hemisphere, this was the shortest day with the longest hours of darkness. This made it a very special node of time, they thought. And the beginning of the next cycle saw ancient Chinese emperors offering prayers on winter solstice solar term. Xi'an, in China's Shanxi province, has a long history of more than 3,000 years. People believe this is where the winter solstice solar term first turned into a Chinese festival, and where it first became an official solar term, one of the 24. If we ask ourselves who knows the most about Chinese traditional culture in Xi'an, it must be Wang Zhi. Working at the Xi'an Intangible Cultural Protection Center, he is a member of this active rescue and protection group, also the first line of defense for Chinese culture. From 4 to 8 to 24, China's 24 solar terms originated 3,000 years ago in the Zhou Dynasty. The winter solstice solar term happens around the same time as the Chinese New Year and is as equally as important. Every year at the winter solstice solar term, Xi'an's Drum Tower Quarter will be alive with ritual noises and prayers, hosting the liveliest of festivals. People trade in various household goods in preparation for the new year.
我觉得你们英国是个海洋国家，它可能掌握这个航海的天气变化。我们在内陆是个农业国家，四季分明，所以自古农民呢就按照这个天，按照太阳来种地，要春天要赶快起来要种地，夏天生长得非常快的，然后到了秋天呢，我们粮食也熟了，然后冬天的时候呢，把各种各样的粮食都汇聚起来，一个是要祭天祭祖，一个是自己要过得好，要吃得好。我这谷豆写上咱们这个二十四节气，在你后边正好是冬至，对，咱们这个节气，对，当地人的这些习俗对这个冬至来说是什么呢？那你就一定要吃饺子了。
Customs of Xi'an and winter solstice solar term are a part of Wang Zhi's research interests. In class, he meets renowned pastry chef Ma Shunli. She has inherited this most Chinese form of intangible heritage dumpling making. Starting at age 16, she has now made, or as we say in Chinese, wrapped dumplings for 33 years.
我确实是每年都会包饺子，但是每年都不会。那你到这儿来了，就会看到这个，可能中国最好的包饺子的技术，看到这个 中国最多的这一个饺子的品种。
哎，你们这多少品种？多少种？
318个品种，百饺百馅百味
儿。你就看他揪这个片片，就光把这个面团揪得一般大，一点不差，这就是他的功夫啊。
基本功就是揪劲儿。擀皮儿，一分钟擀多少皮儿，一分钟揪多少剂子，所以我们就一秒钟一个剂子，它的每个剂子出来的大小上下不差一克。
冬至和饺子有什么关系呢？
你看这个饺子，你看这个饺子，像不像人的两个耳朵？像不像？
有点。
饺子，然后再加点热汤，哎，这个老百姓一吃，大家都不动耳朵了，
而且
都哎可以说身体都好了。
Of all the customs Chinese people carry out at winter solstice solar term, dumpling eating is number one. About 1,800 years ago, there lived a healer called Zhang Zhongjin. He went back to his hometown on winter solstice in one year and found many villagers with frostbitten ears. Zhang Zhongjin ordered his apprentice to cook up some mutton broth laced with chili peppers and herbs.Wrapped it in dough pockets shaped like ears and passed them out to everyone in hot soup. A bowl of hot dumplings in the belly and the frostbitten villagers were healed. Since then, every winter solstice solar term, people imitate the sea by making ear-like edibles. A long time in the making, this tale is the universal backstory of dumpling eating at winter solstice solar term.De Fa Chang is the longest standing restaurant to serve such a dumpling banquet. Nearly 100 years have passed since they began making these superb dumplings. It is now considered one of the legends of ancient Xi'an. More than 300 kinds of dumplings, more than 300 flavors to choose from. Munching on these is an unforgettable way to spend the festival.Winter solstice solar term every year sees De Fa Chang Dumpling Hall at its busiest. All the staff are on from 6 in the morning to 11 at night, churning out dumplings without stopping. Winter solstice solar term is a special day for De Fa Chang. The restaurant can sell a whopping 4,000 to 5,000 dumplings.
要两个手，虎口卡住两头，一边高一边低。推出去拉加进来，推出去拉进来，叫这个饺子劲儿呢在你手中来旋转，转够一圈薄厚就一样了，一高就跟小时候打秋千一样，压压板一样，中间一定要稍微厚一点点，
厚一点，
你看我这个皮儿在灯光底下看基本上都是中间厚一点点，两边薄一点，
速度还要快，
速度要快。
如果人等着吃饺子，咱们包不出来。
对对对，
那就糟了。
这两个手全进来，对，这两个手伸直。把这个扎在这个虎口这块，对，这边这个手跟这一样，就这样子的，两边对。
两个枪。
对，两个枪对住以后看，对折这样压，对，馅不要压出来。
In my memory, every time you eat dumplings, you are meant to be having a happy time.It's either a family gathering or a festival reunion of some kind. Chinese people are very particular about cooking dumplings as one of their favorite foods, and the focus of the collective Chinese mind when happy. A table full of exquisite dumplings, what a feast. This must be a blessed Chinese winter solstice solar term indeed.
样子特别多，我都不知道应该从哪儿开始呢。
好，
小
盘里。
这个是煎的，刚才您吃的那个是烙的，还有这个蒸的，还有烤的。这一款饺子呢叫荷塘月色，这个有莲蓬，有青蛙，有金鱼，刚好吃猪肉莲菜馅儿。说冬天我们在冬至那天吃那个莲菜，每一个节气呢是15天，它每个15天呢就有这个最先生长的食物呀、原料呀，最为人体健康，所以我们就用这种原料来做这个我们的原料和馅心。
每15天我们就可以吃一种饺子。
At different times of the solar term, there are different seasonal delicacies. One tiny dumpling is not only rich in nutrition, but also integrated into Chinese traditional health culture. It is not hard to understand why the Chinese marvel at the flavor, and visitors from overseas love it too. Teacher Wang is leading me on a winter solstice solar term tour of Xi'an, starting with food.When I first came to China, I quickly recognized that there were set customs at different times of the year. When to eat something in particular, and when to wear something special. At first, I didn't completely understand the unwritten rules. That was until I embarked on the 24 solar terms tour. I finally got it. Long-term observation has led to the synchronicity between people and nature, the experience of harmonious coexistence.Qin Shi Huang's terracotta warriors. These seriously lifelike soldiers and war horses are modeled on China's first unified feudal dynasty, the Qin. These are the terracotta warriors. The working people spent their days observing the sun and the moon, charting the growth of their animals and plants. This is how the 24 solar terms came into being this calendar like no other.After the Qin dynasty, we had the Han dynasty, the dominant forces of East, who equals the Roman Empire in the West. These 24 solar terms were confirmed in Xi'an, the capital of the Han dynasty.
我们西安经常有人说，我们是一个地下的博物馆，周、秦、汉、唐，这些历史的朝代的首都都在这儿。就这地下有个非常广阔的博物馆，
是我们现在就是站在这个维养宫，
对，皇上的那个很高很高的宫殿上。据说这一块宫殿，它的遗址的区域，比是七个故宫的大小。
七个故宫的大小。
其实咱们说到这个二十四节气，跟这个地方太有关系了。整个作为一种制度，国家要把它颁布出来，在哪里颁布的？
就在这儿，
就是站在这块土地上，汉朝的首都。颁布的这个朝代可以说是在中国历史上很伟大，所以很多外国人就把我们就叫汉族了。
The Chinese language Han Yu, Chinese characters Han Zi, Chinese clothing Han Fu. Many things are named in reference to the Han dynasty. And this land under my feet, once there was located this powerful dynasty, an imperial palace stood right here. Hard to imagine,Owning a palace seven times bigger than Beijing's Forbidden City, how mighty would this emperor have been?
我们的文化遗产是以两种的形态存在，一种是静态的、物质的，我们看到它一个房子，或者地下的一个文物；那一种是在老百姓的生活中、习俗中，世世代代传下来了。这同样是历史，这同样是我们这一块的。有鲜明特点的历史，所以呢，我们都要传承它，都要延续它。
Undoubtedly, Chinese economic culture and art experienced thousands of years, or even tens of thousands of years of accumulation, then realized a gorgeous bloom in the Han Dynasty. And today, although China's capital has moved to the world-famous Beijing, Xi'an is still alive and kicking.As Teacher Wang said, this historic land is rich in cultural treasures. And Teacher Wang's work is to discover and to protect these cultural heritages. Winter solstice solar term every year is an excellent time to repair farm tools. The popularization of iron tools and the development of farmland irrigation came hand in hand with advances to the complexity in farming.
如果是铸造的话，需要把它烧成铁水，1500度。如果是锻打的话，锻打就烧红就行，烧红可以砸就行。
要哦，冬天干这个还行。
它这个温度非常高了啊。
是。
过去的时候呢，到整个冬天呢。铁匠都是要打农具，特别是 到了这个冬至节，就是农闲的时候，各家都要准备新的农具来年耕作，所以就一定要打基础。
你像以前这大钱，这个钱粮都是在古代几千年遗留下来的这个钱粮这个数字，过去呢就是担个担子，拿个风箱，大钱走街串巷，必须有这个钱粮。
他就这个烧红以后呢，一个铁匠拿小榔头，这个徒弟要拿大榔头。铁匠指到哪打到哪，最后砸成一个样子。
Fixing up ironwork is in preparation for next year's spring plowing. This beautiful window paper cut features best wishes for the new year.
那你每年都是到什么季节才开始剪呢？
就是这寒冬这。没农活的时候，
你是先画图然后再剪？
我不会画啊，我心里咋想
不会画，
我心里咋想咋剪。
这个中国的剪窗花的高手就有这样一个本领，咱们就心里有这样，说剪什么就能剪出来。
这方向，上，转一圈。
然后再转一下。哎呦，好难呢！待会儿，你停一下，我跟不上。哇，那么复杂！
你这个方向吗？看一下。
哎呀，肯定不行。
不是这样来的。
A piece of red paper, a pair of the sharpest scissors, and dexterous hands. This is the folk custom that traditionally goes on after winter solstice solar term. In the cold days of deep winter.When it might be snowing heavily outside, people will spend the hours using bright red paper to cut out beautiful illustrations to decorate their windows and add their wishes for the upcoming new year. Other than traditional paper cutting, people also need another red touch in their lives to decorate their winter nests.
到了冬至的时候，离过年就很近了。就要加紧在家里要编这个东西，
这几天就忙的都要给过年准备。
我们送灯，你们送灯吗？
我们不送灯。
英国人不送灯吗？
我们不送灯。
就我们送灯，大红灯笼高高挂啊，这是也象征我们的生活，美好，越来越红火。
Bamboo sticks as thin as toothpicks are divided up by hand, dancing between dexterous fingers and finally woven into a lantern frame.Lighting the candle in it, the stars burn bright. We imagine them as people on a cold winter's night, sending wishes for the new year and the promising spring to come. When I was visiting the Xi'an Drum Tower, a 10-year-old Chinese child touched me deeply.He pointed to the drum with the 24 solar terms on it and told his parents that these are our 24 solar terms. Now the 24 solar terms are more than just Chinese wisdom and Chinese treasures. They have become an intangible heritage of the world, like the Silk Road of yore, spreading out from the ancient Xi'an, this treasure has arrived at a new millennium.And now faces outwards towards the entire world.